Allahu Akbar.
So, welcome to our audience that is viewing from home during this lockdown. My name is Kashmir Miriam and this is my sister Aisha. Aisha, would you like to introduce yourself and what we do as the Strangers Organization?
Yes, assalamu alaikum, bismillahi wa salatu wa salam ala rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My name is Aisha and I am part of an organization called The Strangers, and our goal is to revive the message of Islam, and we do this through different means. One of the means is through spoken word poetry, through the collective voice of Muslim poets around the world, and just being able to clear up misconceptions. So that's our main goal. Yes, Kashmir.
Yeah, excellent. Jazakallah khair. So the work that we do as The Strangers is we host a lot of poetry slams. A lot of the time they're in person, and so we have our poets go up on stage, they compete for trophies and prizes, and we just have a good time. It's basically to platform the Muslim voice so that we can portray the true message of Islam through the art of spoken word poetry. So it's a creative art. It's something that is powerful and empowering. And that's what we wanted to do for you today. So we have a great show lined up for you all. We hope that you enjoy watching. And I just wanted to clarify a few things that are a little bit different about slam poetry versus written poetry or any other type of poetry, Shakespeare, whatever type of poetry you are into. So the difference between slam poetry is that it is about the content of the poem. So how deep is the lyrical content? How relevant is it to the audience? How powerful is the methods that are used to articulate what is being said in the poem? And second of all, the powerful thing about slam poetry, and probably one of the more important traits of slam poetry, is that it is heavily about the way in which the message is revealed to the audience. So it's not just about reading from a sheet of paper, it's about how that message is delivered. So that's something that we put a lot of emphasis on as The Strangers, and we do with all of our poets as well. So inshallah, today you'll be hearing some slam poetry, and I hope that you enjoy the show and all of the poets that we have lined up. There are three simple rules that we have for the poets. That is, number one, the content has to be appropriate, so no curse words. There is no inappropriate content, and our poets do understand that. The second rule is that we have to make sure that the poem is under 5 minutes. And number three is just to be respectful of everyone that is up there performing. Everyone is sharing something that is meaningful to them, and that's something very personal, and we have to respect that because that's very sanctified. So without any further ado, I would like to introduce our judge for this evening. Her name is Tahani Salah. Is Tahani there?
I'm here.
Assalamu alaikum, Tahani. How are you doing?
Alhamdulillah, we're doing good.
Perfect. So I have, Tahani, your bio here. I'm just going to read it. And hopefully that will explain to everyone your background in poetry. I know Tahani from before. She's a slam poet, so she knows a thing or two, or more than a thing or two, about performance. And that's one of the reasons we chose to have her on our platform today. And that's something that means a lot to us, because I think to be a writer is one thing, but to be a performer is something else. So jazakallah khair for joining us today. So Tahani Salah is an educator, poet, and activist based in Brooklyn, New York, with a bloodline to Palestine. She's a graduate of Columbia University, a former professor of curriculum development at the CUNY Graduate Center. She's also a member of the New Yorican Slam team. She competed internationally and holds many slam titles from Europe to Africa. Tahani has also been featured on HBO's Deaf Poetry Jam. She is passionate about peace and activism and carries that into the classroom as an educator, showing how life creates art and using it all as a tool of expression. As an artist dedicated to bringing light and solutions to communities where people's voices have been silenced, Tahani has performed at a number of world-famous stages, including the Apollo Theater in New York City, to universities in the US, South Africa, Germany, Canada, Palestine, Jordan, and many more. Mashallah. Okay, so Tahani, you told me to pick one or two lines from your bio, but I felt like everyone needed to hear that. So welcome.
In the meantime, we'll have another sister go up, Sister Zainab Rahman. And please do introduce yourself, Sister Zainab. It's wonderful to see you. I've heard a lot from you, and we've emailed back and forth a few times for some other projects that we've got running, campaigns and things. And it's an amazing opportunity, and it's an honor to have you here on this platform. So please do introduce yourself and go for it.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Zainab Rahman. I am 17 years old from New Jersey, and I go to Nurli Man. The poem I'm going to be reciting today is titled Alternate Realities, and it talks about Eid Day and how I realize that there's two groups of people. The first being one that can thoroughly enjoy Eid as an occasion and as a wonderful, joyous celebration. But I realize that's not everyone's reality. That's not everyone's situation. And as you will see in this poem, this young girl that I wrote about belongs to the second group. She only desires for a wonderful Eid. And towards the end of this poem, you'll discover what exactly ends up happening to her. And with that, I'd like to begin. Alternate realities. A young girl sits outside on a cold Eid night. Whoosh! A wicked wind grabs her with all its might. She shivers and quivers with nothing to wear. Fancy clothes she cannot spare. Everywhere, everywhere, houses filled with delight. Yet she only has a single light, a candle. A candle she found on the floor, placed next to a decorated door. She looks through a window and sees children laughing, playing, and having a blast. But this poor young girl only wonders if her candle will last. She cannot return to her wonderful warm home because, unfortunately, the roof has been torn. She closes her eyes and sees an image in her mind, an image of a person that is so divine. Grandma, Grandma, she yells as her heart begins to swell. Come, my child, to this heavenly place. Leave the hardships of this world that you face. Come on now, hurry and haste. We have no time to waste. She takes one last breath and says goodbye to this world of challenges and trial. Oh, only for a normal life was her desire. But no one knows what happened to this poor young girl on a cold Eid night, as the wind had taken her with all its might. Thank you.
Jazakallah khair, sister. You know, subhanAllah, that poem was extremely, extremely powerful. It reminds me of, it was a cartoon, which was on, I think it's on Netflix. My husband, he showed it to me, and it was about an orphan girl, and she was just, I think it was called The Little Match Girl. And it was, it was so touching and beautiful, because you don't normally expect, you don't normally expect to see such like depth, especially with, you know, some cartoons. But it reminded me a lot of that story, and may Allah bless you for that and make us thoughtful of those who are, who don't have as much as we do. Jazakallah khair for sharing, sister.
Yeah, jazakallah khair. And I'd also second that. I feel like your poetry, it has a very classical twist to it, which I find really, like, that's something that I find very inspirational, because I love the classical poets, for example, like William Blake. I felt like you had a hint of William Blake in there. So he talks about issues like that too. So jazakallah khair, it was very refreshing to hear, and I'm sure that our viewers definitely enjoyed it too. So jazakallah khair. Okay, so
I want to thank everyone here. I want to thank primarily for hosting us on their platform. Every single year when we host this, it's just an amazing success, and I can say alhamdulillah from the bottom of my heart. I think this was phenomenally successful. So jazakallah khair. I want to say a special jazakallah khair to Hani for joining us, for doing the very, very difficult job of judging. It can never be.
Thank you so much.
May Allah reward you, and for taking the time out. You're also a mother, so you know, I know it's difficult juggling duties, so thank you for that. And do you have any closing remarks, Aisha?
I just wanted to say that alhamdulillah, may Allah bless all of the viewers for attending. I pray that we all benefited an event without our poets. Now, saying that as well, I'm not sure if you can see me. Okay, you could see me now. no further ado, you can find The Strangers on Instagram. Our website is in the works, inshallah. So please do definitely follow up with more information about the Uyghur campaign, which is a current campaign that we're doing. We hope you enjoyed the letter, the final compilation. A lot of heart went into it from our poets. And thank you again to everyone. And of course, Sister Tahani, you did an amazing job. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And Ikna. Of course, Ikna.
And lastly, I just want to say the greatest thank you to all of our poets for contributing their pieces. Each one was mind-blowing and touched my heart, and I'm sincerely saying that as someone who's been to a lot of poetry slams and heard a lot of poetry over the years, as Tahani and as Aisha can both attest to, we heard an amazing level of talent tonight. So may Allah reward you all. And yeah, I'm going to close it right there. And assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.